sail the sea of faith, find out before too long. How quickly blue skies can grow dark, and gentle winds grow strong. And suddenly fever's like a white water pounding on your soul. But still we sail on, knowing that our Lord is in control. Sometimes he calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. He can settle any sea, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close, lets the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child. He has a reason for each trial that we pass through. Shaken, we cannot be pulled apart from Christ. No matter how the driving rain beats down on those who hold to faith, a heart of trust will always be quiet, peaceful place. Sometimes he calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. Settle in his sea, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close, lets the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child.
A podcast presenting Jesus as the way, the truth, and the life. And now, to the studio and the Wordmaster.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are and whenever you're listening. You're indeed tuned into the Wordmaster Presents, a presentation of the antidote to deception. Today, we are privileged, and I mean privileged, to have in studio with us Apostle Dr. Karen Proctor. I'm telling you, beloved, when I first heard this woman of God present the word of God, I never envisioned that one day she'd be on a little podcast. However, we have her today, and by God's grace, she has committed that whenever she can on a Wednesday, she'll be with us as our chief presenter. So, as you know, when we have new people on, we like to get to know them, and then when they come back on, the floor is theirs. So, today we are going to talk to her, get to know a little bit about her, and have you, if you're not familiar with her, get to know her. Again, her name is Apostle Karen Proctor, and we are going to talk to her right after we come back from our prayer and our theme song for today. And trust in me, brethren. Trust in me, friends. Trust in me, listeners, when I tell you, you are in for a treat. Don't go anywhere. In fact, the where I want you to go to is actually to your phone, to your computers, to your devices, your tablets, whatever, and grab the link and share it out, because you are in for a blessing today here as the Word Master presents Apostle Karen Proctor. Stay tuned. Oh, well, let's pray first and then we'll begin. Heavenly Father, thank you so very much for your loving kindness and your tender mercies towards us. Thank you for blessing our little podcast with this mighty woman. And I trust and pray, Heavenly Father, that as she continues to manifest that spirit that has been an inspiration to me for these past 3 years, that this audience today will just get a taste of what I've been experiencing, what I've been living under for all this while. So I pray that you will bless her, bless this program, bless the manifestation of your word that will come later on. And I pray, Heavenly Father, that what happens on today will be to your name's praise, honor, and glory, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please click on the link in the description to be taken to our YouTube channel and take a few seconds to subscribe.
There's room at the cross for you. There's room at the cross. There's room at the cross for you. The cross upon which Jesus died is a shelter in which we can hide, and this grace. As wide as the sea, there's room at the cross for you. There's room at the cross for you. Though millions have come, there's still. There's room at the cross for you. The hand of my Savior is strong, and the love my Savior is long. Through sunshine or rain, through loss or in gain, the blood flows from Calvary to cleanse every stain. There's room at the cross. Mm-hmm.
there's still room for one. Yes, there's room at the cross for you. Though millions have come, there's still room for one. Yes, there's room at the cross for you.
Yes, indeed, my friends, there is indeed room at the cross for you. And today, the Master presents one who has led many to that cross. So, good morning, Apostle. How you doing?
Good morning. Good morning. I'm doing good. And you?
Very well. So, as usual, I like to ask my guests basic questions and one thought-provoking question. So, the first question is, could you tell us a little bit about yourself and your ministry?
Shaken. I want to first say thank you for inviting me to be a part of Wordmaster program this morning. So, what could I say about me? I don't like talking about me much, but if I had to give your audience something about me, I am a native of Miami, Florida. I am in the prophetic and apostolic ministry. I started over 28 years ago when the Lord called me to take his word to the nations. And I started out as co-pastor and prophetess with my late mother in the church. I'm a mom of three, a grandmother of three. I'm a Christian author of, I can't even count the number of books right now.
I was just about to tell you, don't even try counting. It's a lot.
Yeah, God has called me to write in the Christian genre to help build up his people. I have an online ministry, and also I'm excited about the new Leadership Institute. New in one sense, but not new. I'm excited because now we are able to give out degrees. Well, let me retract that. Not give out, but people have to earn it. So, yeah, we're going to be doing degrees from bachelor's all the way to the doctoral program. And that's a little bit about me.
Awesome. Awesome. I'd like to know a little bit more about the program later on when you have time to tell us a little bit more about what's going on. So keep that in mind. So now I would like to know just a little bit more about Apostle Proctor, not so much the natural, but the spiritual. Where did she get her earliest experience of knowing the Lord, from young lady to the point of being an apostle, and I might say a doctor as well? So could you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I became a believer in Jesus Christ as a child. Thank God I came from a Christian upbringing. My grandmother always took a big, big group of her grandchildren to church with her, and that began to lay a foundation in me for Jesus. And as life progressed, I began to experience Jesus on a more personal level. You know, as you get older and you begin to know not just Jesus of your family, but he becomes real in your life. He allowed me to experience a taste and a measure of the world. You know, I'm not exempt from experiencing the world. But I thank God that I wasn't persuaded to come to Jesus because of any tragedy or some major crisis in my life. I just had to grow in God and turn totally to him. You know, I was born into, again, like I said, into the Christian family, and becoming into ministry, you know, the Lord spoke to Jeremiah in chapter 1 and verse 5. He said, before I formed thee in your mother's belly, I called thee a prophet to the nations. And that's my story as well. But I just did not know it. You know, like I said, God gave me a chance to grow, gave me a chance to experience the world a little. Again, thank God that I didn't experience it to the point of tragedy or experience some major crisis in my life. I thank God that even though I experienced some things in the world, but it wasn't something that took me totally astray from God. Like I said, I just didn't know who I was until the Lord began to speak to me himself. I probably was in my late 20s at that time when I heard the Lord speak to me as far as ministry was concerned. I mean, I would experience the things of God growing up as a child and even into young adult life. But I the things that I was experiencing, I didn't know it was God. I would just say like, oh, that's deja vu. Where do I know that from? So forth and so on. But a prophetic call was upon my life before the foundation of the world. And then one day he just really horned in. I like to put it this way, like sort of like, okay, I allow you to go here and I allow you to go there. I allow you to taste this and taste that. But now it's my time. And so he began to speak to me and say, I called thee. I put forth my word in your mouth to speak forth my word. And, you know, I tried to hide that from a long time, what I was experiencing. And then one day, my mom called me and she said, listen, the Lord told me that he called you as a prophetess. And I just began to break down crying because I was hiding this stuff. I don't know why, but, you know, the Lord was dealing with me and filled me with the Holy Ghost right there in my bedroom when I came from work. Not talking about water baptism. That water baptism was dead when I was a child, but now I am an adult, almost approaching my 30s. The Lord came in my very room and said, I baptize you with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Now, I did not know such thing. No, I did not know any such thing, but that conversion began to happen in my room for a period of time, probably over a month. I will go to work and come home. And after I come home from work, then the Lord will begin to deal with me. And said, he began to confirm that with my mother. And I began to tell her the things that I was experiencing. And from that time, it's just been on from there, from being my mom's co-pastor, being the prophetess in the church. And then I remember her speaking to me one time and saying, the Lord is calling you as an apostle now. And I just like, oh, you know, since this my mom, she just want everybody to do this and that. So that's what I said behind the scene, not to her, but as fate would have it, I met a gentleman one day. I went to his church one Sunday evening. I did not know him. He did not know me. He called me out and he told me that the Lord is calling you as an apostle now. And I'm like, what is this man talking about? But like I said, it's been on from there. And I've received many confirmations that I'm walking out of error. Not that I was seeking any confirmation to know that I was walking out of error, but I mean, in error. But I just said, I received many confirmations to let me know that the road, the path that I am on is called by God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. As I was listening to you, I did not even want to interrupt. Just wanted to let you keep going because, wow, what a testimony. What a testimony, Apostle. Very powerful. I felt like I need to let you go on. But here comes the thought-provoking question, get ready, and it's this. I've known you for the past 2 years, and I've been very much inspired by you. Just reading your history, reading your biography, and even just now, because not too many persons understand that a relationship is something that has to be sustained, maintained when it comes to the Lord. In the natural, they get it, but in the spiritual, they just let it simmer every way. But here, I just felt how personal you want your walk with the Lord to be. And that's my question. With the books, the Leadership Institute, every day you're on prayer and just motivated to serve the Lord. My question is, why and how are you still? I know, personally, many ministries and people who have gone by the wayside in these past 3 years alone. They have succumbed to burnout. They've just like got tired of it. They don't see any reward and they have not reaped anything. But here you are, still going strong. What keeps you going?
That's a good question. I'm motivated to be actively involved in ministry because, number one, I love the Lord. He didn't have to call me, but he did. And I don't take it for granted. That's my number one motivation. Why would he call me? I didn't do nothing to receive this call, you know, so I don't take it for granted. I cannot say some person told me this is, you should do this or you should do that. I had an encounter with the Lord back in the early 80s. I want to say about probably somewhere between 87, 88. I want to pinpoint it as that. I was a very young lady. Loved the Lord as far as I knew to love him. Didn't know the deep things of God. Did not know the deep things of God. Always believed that Jesus was real. And I think that was good enough for me, and I think that was good enough for the Lord. I always believed that he was real, and I knew that sin, what sin was. And so when I sin, I loved God and I feared him so much, even though you know right from wrong, but I would just say, oh Lord Jesus, please forgive me. And one morning as I was waking up, I was in between rams. I didn't know it at the time, but you know, we develop as we, you know, we go along in God. So now I know that I was in between rams because I wasn't fully asleep. I wasn't fully awoke, but Jesus visited me just as I was on the brink of waking up. I don't know if I was woke. I don't know if I was asleep. But I literally saw Jesus with a white robe on a white stallion, and I saw nothing but green pastures. And it reminds me of the 23rd Psalms where he talks about the green pasture, because I saw no beginning. I saw no ending. I didn't see an east, a west, a north, and a south. All I saw was green pastures, and I'm sitting there like picnic style with two ladies that I was working with at the time. Jesus ride up on this white stallion, white robe, and he tells me Luke 15. I did not know so much about Luke 15, Luke 1, or Luke nothing. I didn't know about Jesus riding on the white stallion, but I saw that. And then I literally was able to pull through, and I sat on my bed. I was so mesmerized. I was not afraid at all. It was just a feeling of awe came upon me. And even as I'm speaking, I connect with that feeling way back then. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know if to move. I didn't know if to get up. I didn't know if to go to the shower to get ready for work. I didn't know what to do because I could not believe what I saw. And then, you know, that is my, because Jesus came to me. And then secondly, I'll close it out with the reason why I am so motivated and actively involved in ministry. Because it's my calling and I embrace it with joy. Despite the trials, as you mentioned, the burnout, In spite of the trials, the tribulations, the struggle I encounter, if I wanted to give up, I could not give up. I could not give up because God called me to this. And he says, anybody out there that may be listening, what God started in you, he is able to bring it to an end. And so when I'm burnt out, when I'm discouraged, I know that I can call on the name of the Lord. And when I call on the name of the Lord, he always refresh me to go on. I don't believe God called me for a moment. I believe he called me to ride it all the way through until my last breath. I think I'll be saying Jesus even in my last breath. So I am motivated to know that it takes such a sinner as me, somebody that is not worthy at all, but to put his word in my mouth and to say, speak my word. So I'm motivated because of the call of God. I could make it no clearer than that.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I felt it deeper than my bones. You know, some persons might very well be afraid to share the experience that you did of having that encounter with Jesus. But I know the Apostle Paul, I know you, and I know I had something similar. And when you have that experience, ain't nobody can tell you that Jesus is not real. No matter how hard you try, you just smile it away and you move forward. And like I said, I felt that deep inside my bones. Apostle, we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to get into the next half of our program, and I'm going to ask you, where can the audience reach out to you a little bit more about the Leadership Institute and some of those books you've written and where the audience could get a hold of them. So we're going to take a break right now, and we'll be right back with Apostle Karen Proctor here on the Word Master Presents. Stay tuned. He offers thanks to him. Speaking of seasons, in this season of renewal, this season of change, as we get ready for our holiday season, friends, I just want to remind you that we definitely, as believers, need to be there for our neighbors. We need to let them have this love of Christ that you heard the apostle testify of. I know, listening through your device, you heard the tears in her voice. You heard the emotion in her voice. And so just before I give her over the platform, I want to have her share her testimony with us in a little bit. So we're having a little bit of technical difficulties, but I'm going to get reestablished with Pastor Karen. And while I'm doing that, we're going to play a song as we get reconnected.
No problem.
All right. Sorry about that, brethren. Sorry about that, friends. Sorry about that, especially new listeners. It is something to be expected when the Lord is doing something amazing. Friends, without further ado, Apostle Proctor, can you tell us a little bit about the Leadership Institute, some of the names of books you've written, and then following that, the floor is yours.
Okay, the name of the Leadership is Powerhouse Leadership Christian Institute. We have just got a certification to go to another level. This institute has been around for more than 10 years now, but as I mentioned, we just got certification to go to another level whereby we can issue out degrees now, bachelor's, master's, and doctoral. We're working through some of the things that it requires. We have many classes that are already built, but we're working on those degree programs right now. And you should be able to expect to hear something from us in that regard somewhere around March of the coming year, 2024. But we do have Food of the Prophets, in which I am so passionate about because of what I see people out here doing. We also have the School of Deliverance, the School of the Holy Spirit, and so many other classes that you can take for now that's certificated. And if you decide to turn to go forward for the degree, every class that you take with us in terms of a certificate class can be used as credits towards your degree until we work out all the nuances. Powerhouse Leadership Institute was given to me by God as an apostle, and as some may know and some may not know, apostles are builders. You know, they are foundational ministry gifts, shall I say. They are trailblazers and pioneers. And some people look at an apostle as only building a church. No, that's not the only work of an apostle. We see Paul, he taught, he rent buildings to teach people as he went on. He did so much work in those terms. And so that's part of the apostolic work that God has given me, as well as the writing. We see Paul, he wrote many letters that's included in the Holy Bible. And God is not finished the work that he's doing. And he's still calling people to author work now. I'm not talking about people that's just putting out fly-by-night work so that they can look popular or whatever. But every book that I have written has came straight from the throne room of God. My very first book, Core Knowledge, Vital to a Successful Ministry, that was birthed out of me being a pastor and really just having a needing a standard operation procedures for those that would come behind me, those that will labor with me in ministry, that they would know some of the ins and out of the church. And then Said Ain't So, Power in the Word, talking about the power that's in the Word of God, some personal experience tupled with the written Word of God, His Blood, Supernatural Power and Redemption. It's the third book. Coach Me, Destiny is Calling. I am a Christian life coach. And so that book is written to coach people in a Christian manner, in a non-judgmental way. And then, of course, I have a stream of prophetic books that I have written to help the people that feel like God has called them into the prophetic ministry, or may have the Holy Spirit gift of prophecy, because there is a difference between the person that is called to be the prophet and the person that have the Holy Spirit gift of the prophet. And it's not only written for people that feel like, you know, they are prophets or whatever. It's for the body of Christ so that they can know how the prophetic ministry worked, how God worked through it. So prophets and the prophetic. Then I have the prophetic intel. Then I have false prophets, who are they? And I have, I think, about two more other prophetic books. So that's a part of my apostolic work to help teach and train and cultivate people into ministry, not only into ministry, but just to cultivate people in their walk with God. And so those books also will be used in Powerhouse Leadership Institute. I don't believe that God put me on this run and uploaded all this stuff in me to go and not use it. And so in a nutshell, that's what Powerhouse Leadership Christian Institute is about. In addition to the online ministry, I'm not in the brick and mortar ministry per se at this hour. I don't know what God is going to do in 2024. I don't know if he will shift me back into that sphere. But for right now, I am in the online ministry. You can catch me on Facebook under Apostle Karen Proctor's Ministries. I am there on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, coupling the word with prayer. Prayer has always been a huge part of my ministry, whether it was the prayer line way before social media came out, whether it's our Wednesday night prayer, whether it was training young women how to pray or to develop a life that they would want to pray, whether it was the conferences I used to do, the women conference, approaching the throne of grace. That was a prayer conference. So prayer has always been a part of my life. So if you want to join us on the weekdays, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, you can follow me on Facebook, Apostle Karen Proctor. You can also connect with me on YouTube under Karen Proctor Ministries. And if you want to connect, you have a question you want to ask me about the school, about coaching. I'm also a Christian counselor. If you want to connect with me for coaching, counseling, the books, or any of those things, you can go to my website at www.karenproctor.com. That's KarenProctor.com. And there's a tab on the website that's a contact page. So if you want to contact me for whatever reason, prayer, ask about the school, ask about coaching, or whatever, as long as you make it clear, you can drop me a line on the contact page. Even on Facebook, you can message me as well. And 2024, I want to issue out at least 10 honorary doctor degrees, but there's a prerequisite to that. You have had to been in the fivefold ministry for 10 years or more. You have to give a spiritual resume and also references. And of course, it's going to be a charge. But the thing about it is, you're not going to have to go there and do class by class by class by class. Your work will speak for you. Again, fivefold ministry, apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastors, and teachers with a proven track record of ministry for 10 years or more, submitting your spiritual resume and five references. So that's it in a nutshell. And Brother Peter, is it okay to get into the word now, or do we have any more questions? Okay, well, once again, thank you for allowing me to come and share the word with the word master this morning. And I want to share out of my second book, Say It Ain't So, Power in the Word. And I wrote this book at a very, very tumultuous time in my life. I was a pastor in a church. And at that time, my mom, who was the founder of the church, had fell sick. And even though I was there co-pastoring with her and was the prophetess of the church, now I had to just take everything over. And it was like a hardship, because I am, although I have been pastoring with her for 7 years before her illness, but I was still yet working my 9-to-5 job. You know, I was a young lady, a mom, single mom at that. So there you have my 9-to-5 job, holding down this church, two kids in college, last kid still home in school, and I have to hold down all of this. And it seemed like the seams from my dress was being pulled apart in many pieces. And I still yet remember on a Saturday morning, me and my last child, which is my son, we're on our way to the Bible bookstore and to get some things that the church needed. And I was just so overwhelmed as I was driving. And I clearly heard the Lord say to me, say it ain't so, say it ain't so. And what the Lord meant when he told me that, because he told me what he meant afterwards, I didn't know right then and there, but I reached for a pen to try to write that down even as I was driving, because I didn't want to lose what God was saying to me, say it ain't so. And as I began to ask him further on after coming out of the bookstore and just in God's presence, he says to me, I know what you're going through. I know everything. But what I want you to do is say it ain't so. Now, what God was saying to me, not that it was not my reality. My reality was my reality. But what he was trying to get me to say is what he said about the situation. And his word will keep me and sustain me and help me to navigate through all of the things that I was experiencing at that time. And from there, this second book was birthed out of that word that God gave to me. And so this month of December 2023, the Lord spoke to me on December the 1st, and he told me deliverance is for the people of God. Yes, I do know that deliverance is for the people of God. But what he wanted me to do is minister that word to his people for this entire month, the word of deliverance, that his people will be delivered. And so I want to share with you on deliverance through the word, how the word of God can bring you deliverance. And I know sometimes deliverance seems like such a big word, and it's synonymous to demons and bondage and difficulty and all of that good stuff, as some people in the church may relegate that to deliverance. But deliverance is simply salvation, to be rescued, to bring redemption. And God wants to bring redemption to his people, not just this month, but every day. When we fall in any bondage of the enemy, when we need to be rescued, when we need to have redemption from a situation, and also deliverance if you are not saved and sanctified, deliverance. So this work is very big to me this month. Deliverance, God, just if I can speak prophetically, God just really, really want to pull his people out of situations that they have been battling for such a time. And God does not want his people to leave out of 2023 still in bondage of the enemy, still being oppressed by the enemy, still being depressed, still need deliverance financially, in your body with sickness, relationships, or whatever area it is that you need deliverance. I want to tell you that if you would believe God and if you would believe his word, you shall be established. If you believe his prophets, you will prosper. And so this is the prophetic word of the Lord that he has given me to give to his people this morning. And if I may just share just a little from this book, deliverance through the word. Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 8 says, the grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God endures forever. And so if you will put the word of God on your situation, like the Lord told me when I was going through a very chaotic time in my life, as I mentioned, it seemed like the seams of my dress was going to fall apart, and I'm trying to do everything to keep it together, yet and still I am human. And so God spoke to me and says, say what I have said. And so even though the grass wither, the flower fade, but God's word is going to stay the same. So I want to encourage you to hold on to the word of God. Some people say that talk is cheap and that words are a dime a dozen. Some even say that actions speak louder than words. As for me, I don't believe that words are cheap. You may have heard the old saying to put your money where your mouth is. This implies that you must be ready to pay for what you say, because it can cost you at the end. The philosophy behind actions speak louder than words. It's a one-sided principle. Some people's actions do speak louder than their words. However, the word of the Lord matches his actions, and it will correspond with his word. The word of the Lord, whatever the Lord says, you can be sure that his actions will correspond to his word. The Lord will bring comfort to his people through his word. I don't know about you, but I find comfort in the word of the Lord. Even in the midst of warfare, even in the midst of warfare, you can find comfort in the word of the Lord. I've had the experience of knowing others who share my experience as well. And I want to believe that the listening audience, the Wordmaster listening audience, probably share this same experience, that you find comfort even as you are going through warfare in the word of the Lord. In the midst of going through your trials and your tribulations, I want you to remember that the Lord will provide you strength to stand. God will provide you strength to stand. Isaiah chapter 59 and verse 19 assures us that when the enemy come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against the enemy. This is a promise of God. If you are going through a battle and if you have been in a storm, I want you to hold on to Jesus, hold on to his word. As the prophet Isaiah said again in chapter 59 and verse 19, when the enemy come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against him. Whether through your prayers, people praying for you, studying and confessing the promises of God over your life, or a combination of all these things, I want to let you know that you will overcome. You will be comforted if you remain in him, just like I was comforted as I got the word of the Lord saying, say it ain't so. You must always choose to believe that the battle is not yours. Yes, yes, yes. You may go through battles, but you got to fix your mind to believe that the battle is not yours. Just the victory. Ask Jehoshaphat when he was going through warfare with the opposing army. He was in a battle, but the victory became his because he trusted the word of the Lord from the prophet. He trusted the word of the Lord. And we see in that story that the enemy began to fight on themselves. So I want to encourage the listeners again to stand firm on the word of the Lord. Even as Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 19 encourages, finally, my brothers, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. In the power of his might. We started out with Isaiah chapter 40 and 18, saying that the grass withered, the flower fade, but the word of the Lord remained the same. And this word came to the prophet during the time that the Lord's people were taken into captivity to Babylon because of their disobedience to him. And yeah, we can become disobedient to the Lord, even us today. And this is why sometimes we need deliverance because of our disobedience. And they begin to experience great warfare. They were in need of true deliverance that only the Lord could have provided. Being a prophet, Isaiah received a prophetic word from the Lord to speak to his people, to let them know that the Lord will deliver them from captivity in Babylon and return them back to Jerusalem. And so I want to speak to you today. If you feel like you're in bondage of any sort, you may be in bondage in your mind, bondage in your spirit, you may be feeling perplexed. And I want to submit to you what the Lord told Isaiah to submit to the people at that time. That's Isaiah chapter 40 in verse 1. He says, speak tenderly to Jerusalem. Tell her that her days are gone and her sins are pardoned. Yes, the Lord has punished her twice over for all her sins. Come on. Hallelujah. Even though we commit sins, but I feel, hallelujah, by the unction of God and by the word of God that he gave me on December the 1st, that God is wiping out our transgressions, that God is giving us a fresh start, that God is removing the bondage from us. Hallelujah. Even though you may have been in captivity, in warfare, but the Lord, hallelujah, word remains the same. God is getting ready to deliver his people. If you believe, I'm only the mailman. I'm only delivering the word. It's up to you to receive the word. It's up to you what you do with the word. But I decree and declare by the oracles of God that this month is great. Deliverance is going to take place. I don't care if it's evil spirits have been vexing you or whatever it is. I prophetically decree to you that your strongest enemy combined with a mighty army is no match for the Lord. You will not be defeated. You are coming out as pure gold. Your strongest enemy will fall flat at the word of the Lord, withering and fading, just as grass and flowers do. God is sending the word of deliverance to his people today. Just as he sent the word of deliverance to his people of Israel back then. And I believe that God is even sending deliverance to the Israel today, even as they are going through a spiritual battle, a natural battle with Hamas. I believe that there is a deliverance for the children of God. What a great time to say right now to all our listening audience, say it ain't so, say it ain't so. When the enemy is on your back, we say what? Say it ain't so. Hallelujah. And so as I end, I want to end in prayer. Hallelujah. I want to end in prayer. I want to pray for everyone that's under the sound of my voice. For those that do not know Jesus as their Lord and as their Savior, I want to extend an invitation to you today that deliverance could be yours, that God can give you salvation, that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, that you shall be saved. For with the heart, man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. And so if you confess with your mouth right now and you believe in your heart, everything that Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10 say, that if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, if you make that confession boldly, you shall be saved. Amen. Hallelujah. And I want to pray, hallelujah, for those that are here, those that may come and find the replay, the live viewers, even the replay viewers, whatever platform you may find yourself listening to this podcast. Father, we thank you and we praise you today. We lift your name up on high. We come to you in the name that's above every name, and that is the name of Jesus. We thank you right now that deliverance is the children's bread. Father, I thank you for delivering your people out of bondage. I thank you for rescuing them. I thank you for redeeming them from the lies of the enemy, from the tricks, the wiles of the enemy, whatever they are going through. If they need healing in their body, Father, if they need a touch from you, God, if they're standing in the need of anything, God, whether it's finances, whatever it is, God, if they're feeling weary in their well-doing, God, I pray, Father, for your word of deliverance to penetrate their life from the crowns of their head to the soles of their feet, that it will be well, that they will not leave out of 2023 in no form of bondage. Father, I thank you that you have given us the power to bind and loose. And I thank you right now, God, hallelujah, that bondage of any form, hallelujah, it's being bound up now and we loose deliverance in the name of Jesus. We bind the spirit of bondage and we loose the spirit of adoption, whereby your people are crying, Abba, Father. Thank you, Father, for hearing our prayer, for hearing our cry. Lord, I thank you right now that this word will fall on good ground, that the birds of the air will not choke it up out of the hearts of your people, the wheat on the ground, the tares will not choke it up, Father, in the name of Jesus, that this word will be rooted in the life. I thank you, hallelujah, God, that you come for your word and your people will be all the better as a result of the word that you have given me to share them. And Lord God, I just speak blessings over the Word Master Ministry, God. I speak blessings over Brother Peters, God, that you continue to use him to get your word out into the world. In Jesus' holy name, I pray, amen and amen. And I turn this broadcast back over to Brother Peters.
You've been listening to the Word Master Presents. Please join us next time.